generally I find this disparity between childhood and the energy of childhood and where we end up as adults. It's just like two different universes. I don't understand that. I think part of my own personal pursuit is I want to stay that way as much as I can. You know, I want to keep picking things up and taking them apart or putting them together and maintaining that childlike fascination with materials.
We renovated this 1890s firehouse, trying to honor the history of the place. And I feel like the mural on the outside is now something new that we can impart on the building.
The 2017 summer tour made it to its second stop, beautiful Ithaca, New York.
I think public art is important for so many reasons. Superficially, it just brightens my day to see murals in and around town. But I think on a deeper level, it can convey so many different things. It can inform people about a place, which I think is what the mural on the side of our firehouse does. Public art can just be so layered and so nuanced. You continue to see new things about it that inform you about the place. It's also just a really interesting way to see inside the mind of an artist.
Making art is it's isolation, and being out in the world and seeing the impact that my pieces have on people, mostly positive and even sometimes negative, it sort of just grounds it in this realization that it's a connective exercise, and it's really human in that you're making your mistakes out in front of people.
Ooh. Oh, are you okay?
The way that I'm seeing people take it in, I think it's something that we need here.
Public art can convey a viewpoint. You know, we've got four different artists who are each amazing in their own way, telling a different story on the same wall. The history of their careers is depicted in this art.
Drift on the Road really is you know, raising the bar in more ways than just art, but also just the whole entire experience. And I'm very proud to be a part of it.
The mayor thanked us for putting this mural on our wall. He thanked us for giving it to Ithaca. We hadn't, until he mentioned it, thought about it in that way. But, you know, it is public art. It is owned by us, I guess, but really it's owned by everybody in Ithaca. Anybody walking by, taking a picture of it, driving by. It's such a cool way to engage with strangers. See a process like that in action was really special, something that we're going to remember for a long time. Whatever happens next, this mural is part of this place now. You know, it talks about the history, but it also becomes part of the future of it.
It's a kind of science, you know, that has those sort of free-flowing borders, but it's a science. It's an exploration of existence, and existence is messy. And somehow along the way, we start to believe that things are supposed to be sort of solid and predictable. And to me, that's where death comes in. Like, as soon as you lock into something, everything just starts going gray. The color starts to drain out, and I'm committed to doing the opposite. In some ways, which means just not being comfortable, because a lot of good things come out of discomfort and insecurity. I'm not gonna settle for something that's gonna give me a predictability, because I want to live in that space that keeps me creative and young, I hope. Thank you.